So now let us look at the ledger account. Let's first understand what it means by a ledger. Ledger in actual sense means a collection of books. In the business accounting, it means collection of journals. Why is it called a ledger account? Because it takes out all the entries that are there in journal or many journal books. And these entries get posted into various accounts in the ledger account. Okay. Hence, they are called ledger accounts. You may have heard the word called ledger posting. Ledger posting is nothing but the process of transferring, the process of picking up each entry in the journal book and recording it in the ledger. We do it at the end of accounting period. We don't usually do it in the beginning, okay? And why do we do it? I'm going to explain it. By the way, do you know ledger is called king of all books in accounting world? So how do we do it? A business may have multiple journal entry books, right? And as you know, in the journal entries, we record all the debit entries and credit entries throughout, correct? Now, it is a mix of all different entries related to different accounts. Now, we take all the debit entries from all the journals related to one particular account and list them on one side of the page. Similarly, we take all the credit entries from all the journals related to the same account and place it onto the other side. As per the standard procedure, all debits go on the left side and all credit entries go on the right side of the ledger. Okay. So let's say we have an account called ABC company account. Okay. Now we look out for the debit entries for this ABC company in all the journal books and write all the debit entries on the left side. And we also look out for all the credit entries for ABC company in the journal books and we write them on the right side of the book. And once we are done with this account, we move on to another account. Let's say on the screen, we see cash account ledger. Now we search for cash account entries in all the journal books and we list out all the debit entries and we place it on the left side. And then we list out all the credit entries and then we place them onto the right side. We repeat this process until all the accounts that are listed in the journal entries are completed. Okay, until we finish all the account types that we have used in our journal books. Okay, so once we write the debit entries and credit entries for all the accounts, we sum the totals of debits and we sum the totals of credit for each account type. Let's say we have cash account ledger now, right? We have listed all the debits and credits for cash account. We sum up all the debits for cash account and we get a total debit value for a cash account. Similarly, we sum up all the credit values for cash account. And we get a total of the credit value for the cash account. Okay. Sometimes you may have a higher value for debit. Sometimes you may have a higher value for credit, depending upon the nature of transactions we had. Then what we do is we take the difference between the credits and the debits. The difference amount is called closing balance of a ledger. Okay. Closing balance of a ledger for the year-end accounting. So let me explain what a closing balance of a ledger means. See on the screen. Okay. Let's take the example of the cash account ledger. If we list all the debit entries of the cash account on the left side and the credit entries of the cash account on the right side, and if we sum the debit entries, we get a value of 26,800. If we sum up all the credit entries, we get a total of 2,900. Now we have a debit side, which is of a greater value than the credit side. If we calculate the difference, the debit side balance comes up as $23,900. This is called the closing balance of the cash account ledger for the year end. For some accounts, the closing balance will be on the debit side and for some accounts on the credit side. But you know what? If you sum all the closing balances of all the accounts, the sums would exactly match with each other. Can you tell why? I repeat, if you take all the closing balances of all the accounts, okay, you sum their debits and you sum their credits, you get the exact number. Can you tell why? It is because when we made the entries, we made two events for each transaction, right? Now the general entry rule says the general entry should have two entries, one for debit and one for credit. And the amount of credit should match to the amount of debit. So if you sum the debits closing balance and the credits closing balance, they would also match here. Okay. That is the reason. You know what? A ledger entry is also called as a T-shaped account. Ledger account is also called as a T-shaped account. Let me show it, okay? Because when you write all the debit entries on the left and credit entries on the right, it takes the shape of the T, okay? As you see on the screen. As such, it is also informally known as T-shaped accounts or T accounts. Okay, so one thing you need to remember, okay, nowadays no one is doing a journal entry posting manually because we have software systems in place. A software system would automatically create the ledger accounts with just a click of a button. But as a professional, as a learner, we need to know what is happening in the backend. Once you know the concepts, you will know what the system is doing. So I will also be making an in-depth video again on ledger account, how to do a ledger posting and the pro forma and etc. so on and so forth. So do watch out for these videos. Okay. I hope you got the idea of what a ledger account is. Now let's look at trial balance. In simple terms, trial balance is an accounting report. That is it. It's just an accounting report. And why is it pulled? It is pulled because to make sure that the totals of debit and the totals of credit match each other. Okay. It is in the name itself, trial balance. It is basically an internal report that is taken by the accountants to ensure the debits match with the credits and there are no errors made while recording journal entry transactions. And this is also kind of an audit report just to make sure that there are no errors that happen while posting the journal entries into the ledger accounts. Okay. So how do they check it, you may ask? It's simple. What they do is they take all the debit closing balances from all the ledger accounts, and they also take all the credit closing balances from all the ledger accounts, and they sum up and check if the total of debits from the ledger accounts is exactly matching with the total of credits. And why do they need to check it? They do this audit because they want to validate the information first before proceeding to generate the financial statements. Remember, if there is an error that is made while doing journal entry recording or while doing journal entry posting, the financial statements may not be accurate. But as per the law, companies are required to produce accurate financial statements. This is a kind of an audit that they do by doing a trial balance. And let us see how it is done. Okay. We have assets category account. And these are cash accounts, these are receivables and land and so on and so forth. So when we prepare a ledger account for cash, account receivable and land, we got the closing balances as these on the debit side. Similarly, for the liabilities based accounts, like accounts payable, notes payable, we got these closing balances on the credit side. Now we total the debits and credits and ensure they match exactly. This is how they check. Let's recap what we've learned so far. We've learned about identifying a transaction. We've learned about how to record transactions in journals. We've learned about creating a ledger account. We also learned about what a trial balance is and how do they do the trial balance. Now let's look at the training account. Okay,